Okay. Recording is done, started. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to the online live class. I think as continuation of the last class, what you discussed about error detection as well as correction, we'll try to finish up today module number 3. This is the last topic here. I'll finish off, maybe another 1 hour going to continue with the live class up to 4:45, maybe maximum 5 o'clock. Okay. As you know that in the networking, normally what happens when you are sending the information from one node to another node, the information what you are going to send should be without corruption, without corruption of the data you are supposed to send it. In the sense, the whatever the sender sending the information, right, and whatever the receiver is receiving those information, it should be error free information, right? It should be error free. I can say the acceptable maybe acceptable quality, acceptable error quality, I can say, right? See that, of course, that depends on different applications. If the applications are very critical, where every single bit is very, very important, then, even if one bit is corrupted, then whatever the information you're supposed to be received in the other side is definitely having a different meaning. Suppose if we take some example like a video and audio, or multimedia files. Somewhere if it is got corrupted, what happens? There may be some noise may come sometime, but that doesn't matter. That will not have a much effect on that. That is the reason why I told you, depending upon an application, error detection and correction plays a major role. If the applications are even one single bit make a difference, then you have to take a most maximum care when it comes to error detection as well as corrections. Now, what happens in the error detection and correction? You can see the data can be corrupted during the transmission. That is most of the cases it happens, right? You normally sending the data to a physical media, right? During a physical media, maybe while sending the during the transmission stage, there may be many reasons. There are a lot of interference in between, many other things normally the errors will introduce, right? So some applications require that errors to be detected and corrected. As I said, the multimedia applications, even if a little bit of error is introduced, maybe one or two bits are added to that, it doesn't make much difference in multimedia files, maybe audio or video. There may be little bit of disturbance, then it's fine. We can able to adjust it. But the application where I said is even single bit also makes a lot of sense, then the error detection and correction we need to take very, very seriously. This is what we need to discuss here. Let us first discuss about some issue related to directly or indirectly error detection and corrections. Okay, and types of an error, redundancies, detection versus correction, coding schemes. These are all we need to discuss here. Right. Now there are two types of error happens. Normally introduces. The first type of error we'll call it as a single bit error. See, single bit error, the name itself indicates that there are only one bit in the data unit is normally changes. Only one bit in the, suppose you have a pattern of 1011, maybe one of the bit is instead of one is maybe changed to zero. Or maybe one of the bit, changes from zero to one, right? Only one bit is keep on changes, maybe error occurs. That's what normally call it a single bit error, okay? Second one, we'll call it as a burst bit. This is what the single bit is I'm talking about. Suppose this is what 0000 and this is 0010. This is what input sequence you're supposed to send, pattern you're supposed to send. Okay, bit pattern. Here what happens, instead of this particular bit, you can see, is changed to, instead of 02, changed to 1. Right, changed to 1. So what happens in this, during the receiver side, during transmission, this 0 is changed to 1. So during the receiver side, what happens? The receiver side, it receives instead of 0000010, it receives 0000010, right? This one is introduced here. In the sense, there is error occurred in this particular bit here, right? Now the the meaning of this and meaning of this is totally different, right? What is the value of this? I can say it can be if you separate two. 4 bit here, this may be a 2 and this may be a 0 02 it may be. So when you calculate here, what happens? 0 0 0, this is 0 and this is supposed to be how much? 2 to the power of 3. So how much it becomes? This has become 2. And what is the value of this? Anyone guess it? What is the value, the total value? Yes, absolutely 10. It is going to be 10. Now, instead of you are sending 2, but the other side receiving is 10. This is actually a wrong value, what you're going to receive in the other side. This is what normally call it as error, it's a single bit error. Okay. Now, the next one I'm talking about is a burst error. See, burst error, normally what happens, more than 2 bits are introduced. More than 2 different bits are introduced into the bit sequence what you are going to send it. Okay. That means the data unit have changed. 2 or more. It can be 2 or more bits. We'll take a simple example how this burst error normally occurs here. If you see this particular length of the bits what you are going to send, there are length of the burst error is supposed to be in this case they have taken as an 8 here. If you see this the bit which are sent from the sender, this position, okay, I'll show you this position, this position, this position, and this position, all the position is having 0, that value changed to 1 here during the transmission stage, right? These all 4 bits are corrupted bits now. Corrupted. What happens? Corrupted in the sense is changed 0 to 1. Right? Here in this case, 0 to 1. Now, value of this and value of this is totally different. This is what normally call it as a burst error. Okay? More than 2 bits are, introducing, or maybe bits are corrupted. More than 2 bits are normally get corrupted. Here in this particular case, there are 4 bits are get corrupted here. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 bits are get corrupted. So meaning of this, sender, whatever he sent it, and the receiver, what is received is totally different. The bits are corrupted here. This is what normally call it as burst error. This is what normally call it as burst error. Okay. Now, to detect or correct errors, we need to send an extra redundant bits with the data. Now, before going to this, let us have, we can differentiate what is the meaning of detection as well as correction. Now, as you know that, detection is a very simple process. What you're supposed to do, you have to understand, or maybe you have to analyze the received bit, and you need to find out the valid bits are received or not, right? You have to analyze, or maybe you have to find out bits you're going to receive is a valid or not valid. There is only 2 options, yes or no. That's it. Valid or invalid, yes or no. That's what the easy way, detection is quite easy. But when it comes to correction, what happens? It is not easy as detection. There are correction is a more complex than detection. What you're supposed to do is, see, if you take an earlier example itself, see, you have detected here error here. You have detected error saying that whatever bits you are received in the receiver, that is contains, the corrupted bits. You have detected. But what is the very next step? Very next step is you have to correct an errors. How do you correct it? Before correcting, you should have to analyze which are the bits are got corrupted, right? Finding those bits itself is a complex task now. Why I'm talking about? Because this is a simple pattern what I have put it here. It's a simple pattern, right? But in practically, whatever the message you are going to send, of course, what happens usually, your message is divided into blocks, right? Message is divided into blocks. The blocks will contain maybe, I can say, k number of bits, right? It may contain, and practically there are many number of bits. So finding which position of the bit is corrupted itself is a tedious task. That is the reason why I'm telling this error correction is much more difficult and complex task than error detection, right? And when you doing a correction, you have to detect an error also. You have to detect an error, then you need to correct it. Finding the position where the bits are corrupted, you need to find out those bit positions, then you need to check that particular bit is corrupted or not corrupted. If it is corrupted, then you need to correct those particular bits, either 0 or 1, 1 to 0, you need to get corrected. What are the different techniques for correcting? We'll discuss a little later, but initially we can have this much of information, right? The difference between detection and the correction. Detection and correction, 2 different processes, okay? Detection is easy. You need to find out only error exists or not. There are only 2 answers, yes or no. Valid or invalid, that's it. But correction is much more complex task because you need to find out every individual the position where the particular bit is got corrupted. Finding the particular position is a very tedious process. Okay, this is the difference between what to call it as detection as well as correction. Okay. Now, to detect and correct errors, we need to send an extra bits with the data. Okay, that particular bits normally call it as redundant bits. Okay, you have the message. The along with the message, what is supposed to do? You have to send a one extra bit, or maybe more than one bit. Okay. I request the participants. There is a background some disturbances. Make sure that try to reduce the disturbances. Inform your family members or whoever it is. Make sure that at least for next 1 hour, without any disturbance, let us have a live class. So that we'll, because I'm doing a recording now. Why I'm talking about? Because whatever the recording is done, I'm going to upload it to a Google Drive. Okay. And I'm planning to start my own YouTube channel also. Because those who are not attending, these sessions because of some reasons like technical issues, because of the network issue, whatever it is, maybe they can subscribe to my YouTube channel, including you also, everyone. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel, and whenever you are free, you can just look into these videos. You can do that. Maybe in a day or two, I'm going to start my own YouTube channel. I'll upload all those videos. But of course, apart from that, what I'm doing every time, whenever class is done, these videos will be uploaded into a drive. That link I'm going to publish in the Google Classroom. That also I will do. Okay. Now let us continue with that. To detect or correct errors, what we are going to do, we have to send one or more redundant bits. Okay. One or more redundant with the actual data. Now what actually happens in the process? This is what we'll call it as. Adding additional bit, the redundant bit, what you're going to add it. In the sender part, what actually happens, it contains the actual message. This is an encoder here, okay? This is an actual message. This is an actual message, what you're going to send it. I'll just I'll take it some, okay. Anyways, fine. So what actually you're going to, this is an original message. As I said, the message is actually we're dividing into different blocks, depending upon what kind of a coding technique you normally used. There are different coding techniques. We'll discuss one by one later. Okay. One is a block coding, another one is convolution. We'll discuss those things a little later. Normally what happens, one of the coding is block coding, where the messages are normally divided into different blocks. As I said, each block will contain K bits of, K number of bits. Now, let us imagine this message. Okay. This is the original message you're supposed to send. Then there is a generator here. The purpose of the generator is to generate some redundant bits. Okay. As I said, either you are adding one bit or more than one bit, more than one extra bit you are going to add to the particular message. Okay. Those bits actually generated by the generator. Now, when the bits are generated, the extra generated bit will call as a redundant bit will be added to the message bit. Added to the message bit. Now, here you can see message and redundancy, right? Both the whatever you're going to generate here, this is actually we'll call it as a code words. Message, message and redundant bit, both together it forming one word, right? That is what normally called as a code word, okay? And message is something we'll call as a data word in block coding technique. Okay, we'll discuss that. What is this code, data word, code word, little later. But for your kind information, the message normally calls as a data word. And when so redundant bit is added to this particular message, because you need to detect it, right? For that purpose, we need a redundant bit. One extra bit you're going to add it. One or more. It can be one or more also. Okay. Then you are going to get a message as well as redundancy bits. That's what normally call it as a code words. Now, here a code word is generated that you are going to send it through unreliable transmissions, unreliable transmission or untrusted network, whatever you can call it as. It can be a simple internet connection. Simple internet, it is not a reliable connection, right? In the sense, it is an untrusted. You cannot trust the internet connection, right? That means somebody can hack also. Some attack also can happen. Some, unauthorized person can steal your information. Also, there are many attacks, right? That we have discussed earlier. So this, there is a reason why it calls it an unreliable transmission. Internet is one of the unreliable transmission, public network. Okay. Other way, I'll put it as a public network. Public network is always unreliable and untrusted networks. Now you're transmitting over the unreliable networks, and receiver side, what happens? It receives the information, receive those information. That means code word is received here. Then what you're supposed to do, you have one more component called an checker here. What the checker does, it actually finds redundant bits. It actually finds it finds a redundant bits here. It extracts the redundant bit. Okay, if it is matches, then what happens, you can accept it. Maybe the particular received information, you can depending upon the redundant bit what you going to check it received it, right? Either you can say the received information is correct, or if it is received information is invalid information. If you think if the checker decides that received information is invalid, then it immediately discards. Okay, or if the checker feels that the received information is a valid one, then it accepts it, and the particular message is extracted from this code word, right? That means message is the data word is you are going to get it here in this particular stage, right? This is the code word. Code word will be given to the checker. This is another one of the component here. The purpose of the checker is to extract the redundant bit. Based on the redundant bit, it takes a decision, say that the received message is valid or not valid. If you think the checker thinks that the received information, received message is invalid, immediately discards it. Okay, it thinks that received message is a valid one, and it accepts it, and it it extracts the original message. This is how normal process happens in the adding the bits, error detection here, structure of the error detection. Okay, now of course we need to concentrate. See, there are two types of coding techniques we normally used. One of the coding techniques we used is called block codes. Okay, and another one we call is a convolution codes. And of course, convolution codes is not there in your syllabus. We need to study only your block coding here. Block coding. Okay, in the block coding, there are normal coding as well as the linear coding is also there. Then one more you have the cyclic coding and checksum that we'll discuss a little later. So we need to concentrate only on block coding in this in your syllabus. Okay. We're not discussing convolution codes. Now, what happens in the here? What actually you're going to do? We use in modulo n arithmetic. We use only the integers in the range of 0 to n minus 1 inclusive. In the sense, we use some mathematical terms here. This is some of the mathematical terms we need to discuss. Modulo n arithmetic. This is where the redundancy to find out the redundancy. So many other things. With the purpose of this, we'll discuss a little later how things will work. I'll explain to you. Here actually is XORing the different bits here. See, modulo n in this particular concept, what actually you're going to do, we are going to do XORing. You know XOR operation, what actually does. If both bits are having a similar, then output is supposed to be what? Output is equal to zero. If both bits are similar, okay, then output is zero. If both one of the bit is different, what? Output is supposed to be high. Right? One of the bit is different, is a dissimilar. Two dissimilar bits, normally is output is supposed to be high. Two similar bits, normally output is equal to zero. That's what the XORing operation we are going to do. You can see two bits are the same, the result is zero here. This is an XOR operation. The symbol is an XOR operation here, right? Zero, zero, that means two bits are similar, output is zero. Here is two bits are similar, output is zero. Here in this case, what happens? Two bits are dissimilar, not the same, right? Zero and one. So output is one, here also output is one. Now the result of XORing of two patterns, suppose if you take two patterns, two long patterns, what you're going to do, just one of an example here, 10110 XORing, you apply the XOR operation, then 11111 and 00, right? You're applying the XOR operation here. So in this case, are similar, that means output is zero. So this is dissimilar, output is one, similar output is zero, dissimilar output is one, and similar output is equal to zero here. So resulting XORing of two of patterns is 01010. This is what the resulting of what you're going to read, because it's very important when it comes to a error detection as well as correction in the later stage. Okay, that is why you're supposed to know the XORing operations also, how the XORing operation normally works. Okay, now let us come back to the block coding. What is actually block coding is all about? You see, as I said earlier, every message, what happens, every message you're going to divide into number of blocks. Okay, each block will contain k number of bits will have it. That each block normally call it as a code word, data words. Each block Okay, your message is divided into number of blocks. Each block will contain k number of bits. Okay, each block normally call it as a data words. Okay, now we are adding a, because we need to correct an error, right? So when you transmit along the media, there may be a chances of corruption. To understand that, to know that you're adding the redundant bit. We'll see the just previous slide. It can be one or two, maybe one or more than one redundant bit you're going to add it. Now, see that redundant bit you need to add along with this data words, right? What is the total length you will get it here? This one, n is equal to total length you can represent as n. N is equal to k. K means k number of bits, that is a size of the block. Size of the block, length of the block, I can put it. Okay. Plus R. R is the redundant bits. How many number of redundant bits you are going to add it? Suppose you are going to add one redundant bit, this R is equal to 1. Suppose two redundant bits you are going to add, R is equal to 2 here. Suppose K value, the block contains 3 bits, then K value is equal to 3. If the block contains 4 bits, then K value equal to 4. 4 plus whatever the redundant bit you are going to add it. So together, it forms a one word. That particular word normally called it as a code word. Okay. So code word is nothing but total length. It contains a total length. N is equal to number of k bit number, that is number of size of the block plus the redundant bit what you're supposed to be added. That is what we call as the code words. Now I'll just show you how these data words and code words are looks alike. See, this is about the k bit, right? This is one of the block. This is a whole message. This is out of which it divided into different blocks, right? This is the first block which contains the k bits. Second block which contains another k bits, k number of bits. Then you have like this, so many blocks you have it. Of course, this is another block. Now, when you say like there's a k number of bits, how many number of data words you have it? 2 to the power of k. 2 to the power of k data words you have it. And each of k bits, right? Each block will contain k bits. Each data words, I can say. Each data words will contain k number of bits. Now, I'll give you a simple example. Suppose you have k is equal to 4. K is equal to 4. The number of bits in the particular block is equal to 4. Then how many number of data words you can generate? 2 to the power of 4. That means 16. 16 data words you can able to generate. Suppose if it is k is equal to 5, 2 to the power of 5, the data word, how many number of data words? 32. 32 data words you can able to generate it. This is what normally called it as a data words. Now we have a code word. As I said, the code word is data words plus the redundant bit what you are going to add along with that, right? Suppose the redundant bit, you are going to add two redundant bits, okay? Then what happens? The size of this, so if it is the size of this is 4 plus 2. Now the length of the code word is become 6 now. Out of that, actual message, actual data is how much? Only 4 bit. But remaining 2 bits are redundant bits actually. That is used to detect an error, or maybe we are using for the correction purpose also. We are detecting an error and the correction purpose, that the purpose of adding two redundant bits. Okay, now what happens, you can see 2 to the power of n code words. Okay, because n is nothing but your total length, k plus r. K is the k number of bits, right? R is the redundant bits. Now if it is k is equal to 4, r is equal to 2, then it is become 6, right? What happens? 2 to the power of 6, right? N is equal to 6. Now n value equal to 6 there. What happens? How many number of code words you can generate? 2 to the power of 6. 2 to the power of 6 is how much? Say 64. Right? 64. 64 code words you can able to generate. Now, out of that, what happens? Only 2 to the power of k of them are valid. Got it now? Only 2 to the power of k of them are valid. Remaining, whatever you are going to get it. Suppose, for example, n is equal to 6. Okay? Out of that, k is equal to 4 and r is equal to 2. Now 2 to the power of 4 is equal to how much? 16, right? And remaining 2 bits. Okay, suppose 2 to the power of 6 is how much? Say 64, right? Only 16 data words are valid there. Only 2 to the power of k, them are valid. That means only 16 are valid because 2 to the power of 4, right? Remaining are either used for the remaining code words I'm talking about. Can be either used for any different purpose or some maybe it can be unused one. Okay, it can be unused one, or maybe it can be used for the different purpose. Only 16 only 16 are valid. Remaining are either it is invalid or maybe we can use it for the different purpose. Got it now? That is what the meaning of data words as well as code words. Okay, now, so everyone can listen my word, voice as well as this one, guys. Yes or no? Can you put it in the chat box? Are everyone there? Are everyone there? Can you listen me? Can you hear my voice, please, as well as slides? Okay, good, good, good. Okay, this is about Dataverse and Coverse. Let's move on to what is actually block coding is all about. Okay, so we'll take simple example. Suppose the four block and five block coding discussed in the chapter four is good. Okay, this example. In this coding scheme, K is equal to 4 here, right? See, 4B, 5B is nothing but how many number of blocks you have? Four number of blocks. That means each block will contain four number of 4B, 5B in the sense here K is equal to 4 value. That means number of bits in a block is equal to 4. Then total length equal to 5. The 5 represent total length in the sense how many here? That means valid bit equal to 4. Okay, equal to 4. And one more bit what you are going to add is a redundant bit. One redundant bit we have added, right? That is the reason why n is equal to 5, k plus 1, right? Now, as you saw, we have 2 to the power of k is a data words here because k is equal to 4. That means 16 data words you will get it. Those 16 and 2 to the power of n, there are 32 code words you will get it here because n is equal to 5, right? N is equal to 5. So 2 to the power of 5 is equal to 32. Now, there are 32 code words. As I said in the previous slide, out of these 32 code words, only 16 are valid ones. Only 16 are valid one out of 32. Okay, code words are used for the message transfer. Only you can see we saw that 16 out of 32 code words are used for message transfer, and the rest are either used for other purpose or unused. Got it now? We saw that 16 out of 32 code words are used for message transfer. Only 16 out of 32 are used to transfer the message. Remaining 16, either you can use it for the different purpose or it can be unused one. This is what we in this example says. Okay, now the process of error detection is here. What happens here almost similar to the error correction, maybe error the process of error correction here. Okay, as I said earlier, the difference between detection and correction. Detection is very simple one. Correction is a very is a complex task. Now this process is almost similar, nothing different here. What happens, you can see this is the process of error correction here, right? Error correction. Okay, now see, you are sending the data. The sender sends the data, which is nothing but a data word here, data word which contains the k bits of information. Then there is a generator, right? Generator, the purpose of the generator is to generate redundant bit. Okay, the purpose of maybe another 10 minutes away to get upgraded. Suppose if it is disconnected, I'll send an SMS, send an email again. Okay, we start with another session after 10 minutes again. Don't worry about it. Maybe task for this some upgrading of, because one session is only 40 minutes. Okay, it's fine. Now, what the generator does, it generates the redundant codes. Though that redundant code will be added to the data word here. Okay, it is more one single bit or more than one bit added to the code word. Now, the code word will contain the n bits. That will be transmitted along the unreliable transmission here. What happens, that code word, the receiver receives the code word, right, which contains the n bit. What the checker does in this case also, if whatever the received code word is a valid one, it thinks that it's a valid one after checking the redundant bit. Okay, redundant bit, then it discard it. Otherwise it extract original one, you'll get a actual data word here. Suppose if you think that there is some error exit, then it should to check for error with which is a position you have an error exit, right? And there are many techniques are there to check that. We discuss one by one. Maybe in this case, we'll take one more example. You can able to understand. Let us assume that k is equal to 2 and n is equal to 3. Okay, table, of course, earlier table I'm talking about, 10.1 shows list of data words and code words. Later we will see how to derive the code words from the data words. Okay, code words from the data words. Assume that the sender encodes the data word 01 as 011 and sends it to the receiver. Consider the following cases. Here what happens, the data word is supposed to be what? Data word contains only 2 bit here, 0 and 1. But it added one redundant bit. What is the redundant bit added? One extra bit is added here. The last bit you can see, this is added as one redundant bit here. One redundant bit. Okay. Now 01 is changed to 011. Now the code word is supposed to be what? 011 is the code word now. Code word contains the 3 bits now. Okay. Now, and let us consider the following cases. The receiver receives 011. It is valid code word. Okay. The receiver extract the data word 01 from it. Why it is I'm talking about? Let us see the table. Okay. This is the table I'm talking about. This is the table I'm talking about. Okay. I'll just show you the what is the data between it maintains the table here. Okay. Now the data word we are going to send 01, right? And what is that? This code word is supposed to be 011. It checks every receiver will contain the table. What is the code word for 011? This is 011. It matches to the code word in the table there, in the receiver. It matches actually. Once it is matches, it extract the respective code data words. What is the respective data words here? 01. It matches, right? 011, it matches in the second row of the table. Second row of the table. It checks what actually does. It initially checks the first row. Okay. Initially checks the first row. 011. 011 is equal to 00. No, it is wrong. It will not match. Then comes to second row. Yes, it is matches. Then go to a third and fourth row. Of course, it will not match. So second row, it is matches. Then it whatever the mapped data words is there, that actually it is going to extract. This is the data word which is extracted 01. Okay. That's what I'm talking about in this particular table. Now, the code word is corrupted during the transmission. Let us imagine the code word is corrupted during the transmission stage and 111 is received. Let us imagine whatever the code word you are going to send, 011 you're supposed to send, right? You are sending during the transmission stage, there is a corruption happened, got corrupted. Then the receiver side, instead of 011, it received 111 is received. It checks against the table. Is in this particular table any 111 here? No, right? There is no 111 here in this case. Checks the first row, no. Second row, no. Third row, no. Fourth row is also no. So no 111. Then it decides that what? Whatever received the code word is invalid. Okay. This is not a valid code word and is discarded. Got it now? 111, it is not a valid one. It the checker checks that it is not a valid. So it discards. Then you take another example. Maybe one more case here. Code word is corrupted during the transmission. And 000 is received. This is actually what actually does, it checks for the first value. Checks for the first value. Okay, there is a zero, right? And it thinks that it may be a valid, it is a valid code word. But see what happened, the receiver incorrectly extract the data word zero here. Because this is an invalid one, it is changed. The code word is corrupted in during the transmission. But still it thinks that a valid one because it checks for the first one, right? You see, this actually matches. 000 is matches here. Okay, it received. You can see there is a 000 here. It matches here. It matches 000, right? When it is matches, what actually does the checker, the component called a checker, it feels, it is matches to the particular table. Then it says that it is a valid one. But it incorrectly extract the data word called 000. Correct? Incorrectly. But this is not the data word we have sent it. What is the data word we have sent it? Is 01. 01 is the data word what you have sent it. But of course, he says that it is a correct one because it's changed to this bit is the code word what you are going to send is got corrupted during the transmission stage. What happens? Instead of 011, it is changed to 000. That means how many number of bits are got corrupted here? Anyone? Just put it in the chat box, please. How many number of bits are got corrupted? How many number of bits are got corrupted here? This case number 3, how many number of bits are got corrupted? See, what we supposed to send is 011, that we supposed to send, but the received bit is what? 000. Now, how many bits are got corrupted? Can you hear me, my voice, please? Yes, 2, absolutely. Sushil, yes, it is 2. Now, 2 bits are got corrupted, but whenever the 2 bits are got corrupted, what actually, checker says it is a valid one. Of course, it matches to a table, right? The table, there is an entry. In the table, there is an entry 000, right? So it says a valid and it extract the, respective data words. There it extract the 00, but that is a wrong one, what you have sent. What actually the data word we have sent it is 01. 01 is what we have sent it, but it extracted as 00. So this is a wrong, right? This is a wrong one. That means, what you need to understand here in this particular case is actually this particular case, it checks for only single bit error. It can able to detect only single bit. Got it? It can able to detect only single bit here. Suppose there are more than one bit. In this particular example, there are two bits got corrupted. It unable to detect it. Okay? Whenever, in this case, what happens? If only single bit is got corrupted, it can able to detect. If more than one bit is getting corrupted, it unable to detect it. This is what we can see in this particular example. Got it? Now, this is what I'm talking about. Now, error detecting code can be detect only the types of errors for which it is designed. Okay. Sometime what happens, you know, some application we are going to design it for only single bit error. Sometime we are going to design it for the burst error, burst also. That means you are checking more than one, you are checking for the more than one bit wherever the error occurred. Okay. Depending upon implementation, what you have done, depending upon an application. Okay. Other types of errors may remain undetected in this case. Okay. Now, the structure of what happens here, the structure of encoder and decoder in the error correction. Okay, in the error correction, the structure of encoder and decoder in the error correction. This case, what happens, you can see how much time left out here, time remaining. Guys, I'm just going to disconnect it. I'm reconnecting it again. Okay. I'm disconnecting it currently because there's only 1 minute left out for this particular session. We'll start the new session very immediately after this. Disconnecting it, I'm sending the mail to you again to get connected. Okay, guys, you got it now? Yes or no? Got it? I'm disconnecting it again, I'm connecting it. Okay, thank you.